Welcome to the Reiki Healing Hope Community, a place to heal, relax, be yourself, and be surrounded by those who want to see a blossom and or bloom. I am Jessica. Sup? I'm a Reiki Master Teacher and Intuitive, and today we have a special healing session. It is all about love is healing. So if you're new to the community, welcome, 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 babies. This is your nightly self-care routine. Where you relax, take care of yourself, and do what you need to do during this time. So, welcome, welcome to all my new babies, and welcome, welcome back to my returning babies. Mama loves you. Okay. So we start our session off with a prayer. It is not a religious prayer. It is just a prayer to root us in our individual healing experience. Bring us together as a community and as a collective, and because consent matters, to have your permission to say a prayer. May that you. Dear universe, and all for the highest vibrational good only, please connect us to our highest self and validate information for our highest good only. Please allow us to release what we need to let go and embrace what allows us to grow. Let our journey encompass the lineages, traditions, religions, and spiritual paths that bring light out through us to share with others. I say all of this in the name of I Am, Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. Okay. Love shows up in many ways in our life. First time here with me, you know I really, really emphasize self-love being the key to having healthy love and healthy loving dynamics. But love can teach us a whole lot of things. It can teach us patience, kindness. It can help us self-reflect to make changes. And sometimes love is one of those only areas where we will allow ourselves to be vulnerable enough to explore and make changes. Even if you don't consider yourself a person who is vulnerable with others, the fact that you even have that awareness in that space of love is much more than, you know, perhaps other dynamics in a person's life. Messages. Always feel that when you connect to the universe, divine, God, or whatever it is that you specifically believe in. I tell you all the time, that's your business to figure out what you believe in. That ain't got nothing to do with me. But when you connect to whatever is out there, that is pure, unconditional love. Unconditional. And I talked about this before. A lot of people have fear-based love. Fear-based love in their faith, their spiritual path, their religion. Fear-based love in their relationships, family, romantic, platonic. Fear-based in themselves, being super critical. And I am of the perspective that if love is unconditional, it has to be unconditional. As someone who really, really enjoys history, like y'all know I love history, like I will go down, and I mean like human history, like I go down random tangents about us as a species, you know? As someone who is like that, what I've noticed as I've learned more and more is that a lot of fear base that is surrounding faith and religion is more about control and less about actually the meat and potato of the religion. All of these kind of rules and regulations that are pretty much socially struggle with self-love. Because if at the core of your understanding of the divine is conditional, you make your own self-love conditional as well. But the core of your structure with the divine, the universe, is unconditional. You then stop requiring yourself to have to be at a certain place in life, have to have a certain thing before you start loving yourself and really truly appreciating yourself. And that can be really hard to realize, because we live in society. You know, we have societal norms, different societies, different norms, but us as a species, we tend to kind of collect in groups. And in order to be accepted by a group, whether that is, you know, a clique or a larger society, there are certain norms and there are certain rules. And the moment that a person realizes that on the individual journey, the rules are not as helpful, maybe on a social, a systemic kind of group dynamic is a little bit different, but on an individual level, those rules are not helpful. I think it puts the person in this kind of existential crisis, because what do you do when everything around you is reinforcing a type of toxic love, but you truly are on your healing path to something better? Now, it doesn't mean that all societies are bad because they have rules and stuff like that. You know, it probably would be complete anarchy if there weren't any rules. But I think that we can, you know, I think that we can separate and coexist between the two. We can be in a world where there are certain rules and expectations, but what is, you know, great for the gander may not be good for the goose. You know, I hear this all the time, because what I notice when I look at kind of like the big picture of things is a lot of people want to get out of whatever they're stuck in. Maybe they're stuck in relationship dynamics that are not working. Maybe they're stuck in a certain socioeconomic situation. Maybe they're stuck in a certain health condition, and they want to get out of it, but they will only use the parameters that have already been preset in order to be successful. Versus as an individual, there are numerous ways, you know, millions of ways to get out of whatever is holding you back. But when you go by already pre-established routes, there's only thousands of ways, or maybe hundreds of ways, so it limits you. So I'm of the perspective that any person can completely, drastically change their life on their own. But just because you drastically change your life doesn't mean that society will drastically change how it interacts with you. Does that make sense? We gonna get to the love, babies, but I just kind of want to explain to why these seeds are planted for how people could, you know, feel about love. But just because you drastically change your life doesn't mean society follows through. I am still a black woman. I'm still a gay woman. I'm still a woman who, you know, comes from a lot of also, if you have more privileged identities, it's also going to be difficult to make changes. You know, it's going to be difficult to want to transform the soul, because if society is propping you up, it's going to be hard to make changes in love. It's going to be hard to make changes in how you see the world and actually doing more meaningful things, because why would you, you know? So I said all of that to say, you are never truly stuck. If you ever feel like in love that you don't have the love you're looking for, that the right person has not shown up, that you just don't feel good about yourself, that you feel very conditional, like, oh, when I look this way, or when I have this thing, or when I'm at this space, or when I make this amount of money, or, you know, whatever it is for you, then, you know, the right person, I hope the right person shows up, or I hope that my parent will treat me right, or I hope that, you know, or I'll be surrounded by friends that are, you know, X, Y, and Z. Baby, when you put conditions on the love that you have for yourself, love will never come. It won't come, or it will come in a very conditional way. And the crazy thing about it is you'll probably outgrow the condition before it shows up in your life. So having this connection to the universe in a very unconditional way of just, you know, universe, love on me. I'ma love myself, you know. I was like, I'm gonna love on myself. Universe, love me. And I'ma love myself. I'ma love myself wholly, because I think the most respectful thing that we can do as, you know, energy in the universe is to just be grateful to be energy in the universe. To evolve. You know, I think that in our evolution as a species, in our evolution on this planet, you know, all of the living things on this planet, we're moving closer and closer and closer to a higher understanding of things. You know, earlier in our species, okay, this is my little tangent, earlier on in our species, we probably were much more fight or flight. We probably, well, actually, I would think that, you know, single-celled organisms just getting there and learning to develop, like, eyes and, you know, hearing stuff, you know, but let's say we're jumping in time and, you know, we're kind of fully formed beings now, and we're much more, you know, fight or flight. We're much more in just in that moment, in that adrenaline, just trying to survive by, you know, finding our meals and things like that, which is, you know, unfortunately, in a modern world, people are still trying to survive to simply just get meals. And, you know, during those times, it would make sense that our body would be in a constant state of anxiety to keep us alive. Now it doesn't really make sense. And the anxiety probably comes from, we have a lot of, like, stimulation. We have a lot of mental stimulation. We have a lot of information. You know, this is the age of information. So we have a lot of information being thrown at us at one time. And that can just completely boggle down the brain, you know. The brain needs rest, even if we're not physically taking movement. The brain still needs rest. And if you have all of these social norms, this is how you should be in love. This is how a relationship should go. This is how you should love yourself. Nope, I changed it. That's how that you should love yourself. It can just be so overwhelming on various levels. And so when I say love is healing, what I'm saying to that is you have to separate yourself from the individual in the systemic. When you really want to work on making changes, when you really want to transform your life, you got to sit in the individual energy and say, fuck all this shit. I'm gonna be over here in the individual, and I'm going to drastically change things. I'm not gonna let people treat me crazy. I'm not gonna treat people crazy. Any goal that I want it to be meaningful. I don't want to just say I want something. I want it to be meaningful. Anything that is in my heart is possible to happen. And if it doesn't happen, it's because there's something bigger and greater along the path. And, you know, five, I don't have another, a fifth, but, you know, that's the energy. And sometimes you got to separate yourself from people. You yourself. Take care of yourself. You know, take a break, you know, from that energy and just treat yourself. Demonstrate to yourself how you would want a partner to treat you. Demonstrate to yourself how you would want your family to treat you. Demonstrate to yourself how you want your friends to treat you. And after a while, you set a standard for yourself. You create a routine for yourself. You create an expectation. So when you reintroduce yourself to your family or new people, you expect a certain thing. And they gotta straighten up or ship out. They cannot be in your energy, in your space, if they don't do that. But when you never take yourself out of that environment, you will constantly make excuses to kind of drag people along and allow them to treat you in a type of way. And the way we allow people to treat us is a reflection of how deserving we feel of love. And the purpose of love is not that. The purpose of love is healing. You know, if you've ever had like a really difficult medical condition that you've got to the other side, some experience a sense of, wow, this was trying to tell me something. And seeing the beauty and even kind of the darkest of those times. But also, it doesn't mean that now you just have to live by a standard where you gotta get gravely sick in order to learn something. No, you understand that that sickness told you something so that you would never have to go back there again. But maybe you were unaware before. Maybe you didn't realize how you were treating yourself or how you were allowing other people to treat you. And that psychosomatic condition manifested in that ways. But now when you know better, you do better, because there's like a little bit of